NGJCL, it's your secretary Madeline, and today I'm so happy to announce that we are introducing our series of food vlogs. So if you want to see your favorite NGJCL officers make world-class dishes like creme brulee and pizza and other things I can't even pronounce, stick around, eat with us, it's going to be great. Alright, so starting out strong, we have Sarah the Pizzeria. So, she's doing it from scratch. She got that yeast. Those bread making lessons in March really paid off. Look at that dough. Look how she is just mixing that. So impressive. Alright, now we're moving on to Alright, now we're moving on to some prep. So we're gonna violently crush the garlic because this is how Sarah takes out her anger, clearly. Dice it up real nice. Move on to some onions because, you know, sometimes you just need to let it out. Let out the tears, Sarah. It's okay. Alright, now we're assembling the pizzazzas. Got those pepperonis on there, shrooms always. This white sauce, cheese, chicken. These pizzas look so good, Sarah. Can you please send me some of this? Into the oven they go. Unfortunately, it is not a brick oven in John's backyard. That was the first option, but we couldn't quite work it out. Look how beautifully they cook. Wow. Just my compliments to Chef Sarah because these pizzas, 10 out of 10. Lovely.
Welcome to my cooking vlog. Today we are making creme brulee. A whole bottle of heavy whipping cream. Need 1 tablespoon of one teaspoon of vanilla. Turn it off. Mixy. The heat and cover it. It has to sit for 15 minutes. We're gonna cover it now. Perfect! Now set a timer for 15 minutes. Preheat the oven to 325. Brulee, we need 6 egg yolks, and we already have one. We already have 5 of them in there, so I'm just gonna add an extra one. Yep. All right. There's our 6 egg yolk. We need to add 1/2 cup of sugar. And then 1/2 tablespoon of vanilla.
Teaspoon.
1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. All right. Then we mix it together until it starts to turn a light color. All right, so we just stirred the ingredients and it looks like this light color. And now what we're supposed to do is we're supposed to add the cream from before a little bit at a time and stir it continually. Yummy. All right, now that we finished mixing it, it looks kind of like this. Whoa. All right, we have moved our creme brulee mix into this pour, and now we're gonna pour it into 6 little pans. Ramekins, 6 little ramekins. We just finished pouring them all into their ramekins, and now we're gonna put them in the pan and fill the pan with water. We're putting it in the pan. We're gonna bake the other ones in a different pan after. So now we need to take hot water and put it in the pans so it's 1/2 the size of the ramekin. We're pouring very carefully. You don't wanna get any water in the ramekins because that's bad. Just a touch more. There we go. Now the water's around 1/2 the ramekin. The oven for 40 to 45 minutes at 325. Okay, so our oven just beeped and we're gonna take it out now, and it's supposed to be crusty on the edges and a little bit like juggly jello in the middle. There's your little jiggle. A little jiggle. All right. We have to let them cool for a few minutes, and then we're gonna stick them in the fridge for around 3 hours. After they finish cooling off, cover them with plastic wrap and put them in the fridge. So after we've let it cool for 3 hours, we have to get some sugar and then sprinkle it on top. Then I'm gonna spread it out. All right, and after we spread it out, now we're gonna blowtorch it. We did it. How do you turn it off? After you've hardened it, you can enjoy it with any berries or just plain, and it tastes very yummy.
Oh my god. Hey NGJCL, what are you doing in my fridge? Come with me. Let's make a snack. Alright, so first we're gonna hit up the vegetable drawer. Grab some celery sticks, throw them in the oven because you gotta cook your celery, right? You know, that's what we do, right? Throw it in the oven. Nah, I'm just kidding. That's not right. That's not what we do. You're gonna dance with your celery a little bit. Open her up. Yes. Look at those stalks. So fibrous. Yes. Dance around a little like you're Phil Collins. Do some fencing, maybe. You know. Give those babies a nice wash, because sanitation and hygiene is very important. Give them a nice scrub-a-dub rub-off, and boom, there you go. Bite into that. Oh, wait. I just realized we forgot the most important ingredient. So you're going to want to shuffle on out to your garage or, you know, wherever. Hit up that car and check your glove compartment for sauce, because sauce is the boss. I'm grabbing my McDonald's ranch because that's clearly superior, and then you're good to go, you know? You got your ranch, got your celery, go ahead and eat that stuff in your garage. So yummy. Thank you. Alright guys, that's it for this first vlog. Thank you so much for watching. We hope you enjoyed watching us become chefs, and don't forget to tune in for next episode.